Hi, this is Jason from Second Sense Audio. You're looking at Wiggle, a dynamic wave-shaping synthesizer we just released. Today, I'm going to show you the primary functions of the synth by programming a sound from scratch. First, we need to reset all parameters to default by initializing the current preset. Okay, let's get started. Let's choose a different type of waveform as the starting point, and drag the control points to adjust the timbre. Now use the shaping function to increase the complexity of the sound. And with phase distortion, you can add more frequency content. And you can customize the phase distortion waveform. I want to modulate the phase distortion depth to make it sound more lively. And by double-clicking the knob, I can adjust the modulation range. Now I can modify the modulation envelope. I want to adjust the amplitude envelope to make it sound a little bit percussive. Now let's add another sound generator to the mix. There's too much high frequency content. Let's add some filtering. And modulate the filter cutoff frequency. Switch the modulator from LFO to envelope mode. Now we can loop a portion of the envelope. I want to add another sound generator to the mix and bypass the filters. And solo this OP so we can focus on adjusting its sound. Now let's try the built-in LFO for the control points. This is the signature feature of Wiggle. Now I want to route it to filter 2. And modulate the panning. The color-coded FM matrix shows the modulator-carrier relationship. Now OP4's frequency is modulating OP3.
One.
Now let's use a sequencer modulator. It's located in the sequencer page. I want to thicken up the sound by using the unison function. Unison can increase the output quite a bit, so make sure to attenuate the master volume. Randomizing the starting phase of the wavetable while the unison width is turned up can help widening the sound. Now let's look at the morph pad. You can save 4 snapshots of the sound and morph between them. I'm going to add some effects and then take the snapshots. Okay, that's the first snapshot, and I want to adjust the sound and take another one. Now let's try morphing between the snapshots. Turn on motion to let morphing occur automatically. And try different transition effects. Okay, let's play around with the sequencer. I want the sequencer and morph pad to work together to make a very animated sound. I can randomize the control point to quickly change the timer. And I don't want this modulator to be re-triggered every time a note is generated. I want to program a polyphonic pattern, so I need to switch to the custom mode. If you're happy with the sound, save it and make sure you fill in all the necessary information so in the future you can easily locate the sound from the preset browser. I have covered many functions of Wiggle in this video. The best way to learn it is by experimenting. You can also look at other presets and see how they are made. We made the user interface very intuitive, so you can easily find out what techniques are being used to craft the sound. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy designing new sounds with Wiggle.